Shepherd of our soul, Shepherd of our soul,
Savior of our soul, Lover of our soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up.
We exalt your name for yet another day. Thank you for making it possible for everyone of us to see this day again. It's not by power, it's not by might, it's by your mercy. Father, you did it for us to look back at yesterday, to know those things we ought to have done that we didn't do, to see where we have missed it, to rectify it again. Father, many people don't have this opportunity. Today, they are dead and they are in where they never thought they would be. Jesus, say glory and honor be given to your name in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, just as you do use others on this mountain to speak to us, use me this morning for I am available. Talk to me and talk through me to the end that we all be blessed to your glory alone in Jesus' name. Satan, you are God. I chase you away right now. Every spirit of destruction, I bind you, you Leviathan spirit. I cast you away right now. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
This morning we have a message titled, Establish a No-Go Area. Establish a No-Go Area Zone. Establish a No-Go Area Zone. But then, until a man have a no-go area zone in his life, you are not yet ready to make heaven. Now, I want to ask you a question. Do you have an area in your life called a no-go area? A no-go area zone. It will be told that, hey, don't even go there. When you come to this thing, don't dare that woman. When you come to this, don't even try. He will never allow you. She will never allow you. Mr. Man, we are not careful to answer you in this case. King Nebuchadnezzar, in this very case, this is a no-go area zone for us. Bowing down to idol, we don't even play with it. Don't even try to say it, we will not do. If God don't save us, we are ready to die for this. Woman, when it comes to committing sin, I will not do this evil against my maker. I will not sleep with you. Nothing will make me to sleep with you. This is a no-go area zone. I will not do it. Do you have a such a thing in your life? Call a no-go area zone. When it comes to committing sin, don't even dare it. When it comes to convincing somebody to sin against God, to lie, to cheat, don't even, that woman, don't even dare it. If you must carry your phone to call that woman, be careful what you are calling her for, because when you call her for so thing, she will show you. She don't play when it comes to the issue of herself and of her father. Not even her husband can convince her to sin against her father. Are you somebody like that? Have you come to a point that you say, no, this is the line that I've drawn. This is a no-go area zone in my life. Nothing can cross that place. The Bible told them in Revelation chapter 3, verse 11. Behold, I come quickly. Behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. Have you made the issue of your crown a no-go area zone? When it comes to protecting my crown of salvation, it's a no-go area. I will not drop my crown for nothing. I will never, no man, no amount of money, no amount of position, no amount of possession that will make me drop my crown of life. When it comes to my crown of life, not even my husband can make me to drop it. When it comes to my crown of life, it's a no-go area for nobody. Not even an angel from heaven that I will allow to take my crown. Have you come to a point like that? He says, behold, I come quickly. Take heed. Beware that no one take care of your crown. That nobody take away your crown. So how do you value your crown? Are you somebody that common biscuits can take your crown away from you? Are you somebody that common document can take away your crown from you? But I'm here to let you know this. Until you have established a no-go area zone, where there's war, there's woken a no-fly zone. Any flight that fly over there, that flight will be brought down. Anyone that cross this line, I will bite him. When it comes to taking my crown, I don't joke. Not even a friend, not even a co-pastor, not even a wife that I will allow to take my crown from me. Have you come to that point in your life? Until you come to that point in your life, brother, sister, forget about heaven. You will not make it. Until you have been able to establish a no-go area zone in your life and say, with this, I will not joke with this. You can joke with me with every other thing. You can play with me with every other thing. But when it comes to my crown, don't even take it. The Bible told us in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 27, that he may present it to himself a glorious church. No hiding spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy without blemish. That it should be holy without blemish. He's talking about your eye. A holy church. Now, have you created a no-go area zone around yourself? I say no. When it comes to holiness and righteousness, don't dear me. Don't call me and start backbiting. You will not take me away from the road of heaven. Not even you can make Christ to come and see filthiness in me. Not even you can make Christ to come and see spot in me. Don't recall me. Don't put spot in me. I'm not ready to give down my salvation for you. No matter how I love you, I will not love you to the extent of dropping my salvation for you, because the Lord has told me he's coming for a glorious church. I want to remain glorious for him. Mr. Man, don't stain me. When it comes to stain, I won't take that from you. You can do any other thing, but when it comes to staining me, don't dare it. I will not take it from you. When it comes to restitution, don't, even though you are my husband, you can't stop me from restituting. Because this is a connection between me and my salvation and my God. Not even you, my husband, can stop me from restituting. Not even you, my wife, can stop me from keeping myself pure. Because this is what the Lord says. He's coming for a spotless church. I want to remain spotless. So I'm making my body, myself, a no-go area. Don't dare me when it comes to serving my God. Don't dare me when it comes to keeping holiness and righteousness. Because I have come to understand that this is what will make me to fly away with him on that day. This is what will make me a glorious church. If you stay me, I am no more glorious. I'm not dirty. And the Lord is not coming for a dirty person. Luke chapter 21, verse 31. Luke 21, 34, rather. And take heed to yourself. Take heed to yourself. Lest at any time your heart be overcharged with sovereignty and drunkenness and care of this life, and so that the day coming upon thee unaware. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, am I missing it somewhere there? Please, I must please check it. And take heed to yourself. Let any time your heart be overcharged with sovereignty and drunkenness and care of this life, and so that the day come upon you unaware. Brethren, we must be careful. Put a no-go area in everything you are doing. Not even the care of this world will take salvation from me. Not even the excesses of things around me will take help from me. When it comes to the issue of heaven, it is called a no-go area. I will not allow my heart to be overcharged. Hey, look at money. Look at wealth. Hey, wealth will not wealth away my salvation. I will not allow money to milk out my salvation. I will not allow wine and drink to drill out away my salvation. Nothing on earth is able to take me out of the way of God. Have you been able to establish yourself in such manner? No amount of euro, no amount of pounds, no amount of dollar will make me to change my mind for the Lord. Make a no-go area zone in your life today. The Bible told us in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 9. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders, and with all deceivableness and unrighteousness in them that perish, because they receive not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause, God shall send them a strong delusion. God shall send them a strong delusion that they should believe a lie. And this one is happening today. Many Christians have not been able to establish a no-go area zone in their life, saying, even no miracle will make to bow down for Satan. Let them be doing miracles there. No matter what TB Joshua is saying, as far as their various trials are there, it's not real to me. As far as he's not preaching against sin, as far as he can allow sin to dwell there, that means whatever they are doing that is not of God. Let me die in this sickness. I will not bow down for Satan. I better die sick and make heaven than to be healed on earth here. Maybe when I'm healed there, as I'm coming back home, accident may happen and die on the road and go to hell. Because of this, I will not allow the working of Satan with power and signs and lying wonders to make me go to hell. Therefore, it's a no-go area for me. I will not bow down for miracle. I will not bow down for signs and wonder. I will not bow down for the flatteriness of men. I will not bow down for the flattering words of men. Nothing will make me to compromise when it comes to me and my God and making heaven. But today, many Christians have not come to this point. They are moved by little things, a miracle, a signs and wonders, and they are not checking what is happening there. Praise Master Jesus. Yesterday, a sister called me. I asked if my friend was there. I asked his sister, "Are you a Christian?" Say, "Yes, I am a Christian." "Do you go to church?" Say, "Yes, I go to church." "What kind of church do you go to?" He said, "Just like every other normal church." "My church is like every other normal church." "What is every other normal church?" In any church that It's like normal church. Anything can happen there. Okay, sister. Is your pastor preaching holiness? Yes. Okay. Does it allow so? We don't even know if such a thing exists. The woman not wearing trouser, not making up, not wearing. We don't know in our church. Okay, that means it's actually like other normal churches. Are you like other normal Christian? You are not. There's no difference between you and other Christians. You are going to hell. You will land in hell. You must be different. I cannot be like other normal pastor. I cannot be like other normal apostle. There must be a difference between me and every other person. The Lord Jesus Christ is seeing and say, yes, this my son is different from every other person. A thing that other allow that he can never allow. No matter what, this young man had been able to draw up a no-go area in his life. This my son cannot easily be cajoled like every other person. This my daughter is not easily cajoled like other person. But if you are a Christian like every other normal Christian, you will also go to hell as every other normal Christians are going to hell. You must draw out your difference. You must make a thin line between you and every other normal Christians. Madness, solution, and redemption premise worldwide must make a difference between every, even between other churches that are preaching holiness. We must go deeper. We must go to the root of holiness and righteousness. We must be a people who never allow what other people are allowing. Okay, no problem. It's just only this one. That only this one is what will take you to hell. Okay, we don't allow fornication here. Okay, let us just we can allow. No, that one you are trying to compromise with is the one to take to hell. Must make a difference with everything. The Bible says, and that is what we do. No plan of hell. Every other churches who are preaching holiness and righteousness. They say, okay, they can plant it, but on this mountain, we are going by the word of God. He said, no planting of her. We have drawn a line there. It's a no-go area. We will never disobey God. We will never disobey the word of God. Have you been able to sit down and draw out a blessing? No. I want to be a Joseph of my generation. Woman, I will not defy myself. I will not do this against my God. Take away everything from me. I know when your husband comes, there's no way he will believe me. I know he will take a position from me. He will even arrest, no problem. But what you are telling me to do is something I can never do. King Nebuchadnezzar. Say yes. Say with this, we are seeing the fire burning. We are hearing you telling them to even increase the fire. We know what? We have made up our mind. We are ready to go into that fire that have limits, that can burn maybe 2 days and quench. Than going to the dark fire that you cannot see. The other fire we are seeing somewhere that will be burning for 2 million years, that will be burning for 10 million years, and is not ready to quench eternally. We prefer to go to this world that can burn for 3 days or 5 days. Gather all the firewood, all the fuel in your land, and put it there. A day is coming, the fuel finish, and the fire will be quenched. They are ready to enter this fire now. They are going to fire that somebody that is blowing it, we cannot see. Sister, choose ye this day to face the wrath of your husband that can stop at maybe after 3 years or 5 years. Choose ye this day to incur the wrath of that pastor who chased you out of congregation and you go to your house, offend the wrath of God that we burn forever. The Bible says their smoke rise up forever. Today, I want somebody on this mountain to draw out a no-go area zone. When it comes to gossiping, don't call my line. When it comes to lying, don't even dare me. When it comes to backbiting, don't come to my house. When it comes to stabbing others at the back, don't even dare me. When it comes to try to pull others down to go up there, don't even climb my ladder. It's time to make up your mind today. Yes, if you are practicing Christianity as others are practicing it, you will go to hell. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. I have no more time again. I'll just read this verse and we close. Ephesians 5:5-11. I just read it through. For this you know, and no homemonger, nor unclean person, nor covetous man who is an adulterer have any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. 6. Let nothing deceive you by vain word. For because of this thing, cometh the wrath of God upon the children of disobedience. Be not ye therefore partaker of them. Draw out the line. Be not ye therefore partaker of them. Verse 8. For ye were sometimes darkness, but now are light in the Lord. Walk as children of light. When I was not born again, you can call me and say anything, I will agree. But now I am born again. I should live as somebody who is born again. When I was in darkness, you can tell me about bribing, I will do it with you. You can tell me, let us go and do this, I can do it. But now I am no more in darkness. I'm now light. I will shine forth who I am. I've drawn the line between Emmanuel and worldliness. I've drawn a line between godliness and worldliness. What about you? Verse 8. Verse 9. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all godliness, all goodness, and righteousness, and truth. For the fruit of the Spirit is in all goodness, and righteousness, and truth. Proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. Proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. If it's not acceptable unto the Lord, I cannot do it. Don't tell me to do what is not acceptable unto God. Don't tell me to fall in the place where God will not follow me to. Don't tell me to gather with you to do what God will not do with me. Oh, Jesus. Ah, God. My heart is level. I have no fellowship. I have no fellowship with the unfruitful works of darkness, but reprove them. Brother, reprove them. When that friend calls you and starts saying some things, reprove her. This is an issue between me and God. Don't come align and separate me from the lineage of God. I will not allow you. You are my friend, but not to that extent. Brother, sister, establish a no-go area zone in your life today. This is the word my father gave me last night. And I believe, if you also do it, it will be good for you. I should establish a no-go area zone in this ministry. I should establish a no-go area zone in my life and in my family. And I believe the world is not for me alone. I should also extend it to somebody who cares to listen. And as I do this, and you do this, and we stand by it by the power of the Holy Ghost, heaven is sure for us. In Jesus' name, amen. Are you out there? You are not born again. Don't even try to establish it. You cannot. You cannot. Except you are born again. Heaven cannot back you up when you establish it. Say after me if you want to give your life to Jesus Christ. Say, Lord Jesus, I've heard your word. I love what I heard. I want to be a part of this. This I can do without you in my life. Jesus, have mercy upon my soul. Forgive me of my sin. Purge me from every unrighteousness. I renounce the devil today and his works. I accept you, Lord Jesus Christ, as my Lord and personal Savior. I am born again today. All things have passed away, and all things have become new. I receive power today to establish a no-go area zone in my life. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for sending your word my way. Thank you, Almighty God, for pulling me out of hell. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for giving me ear to hear and the mind to do. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. If you have declared this declaration, I rejoice with you. The Lord Jesus Christ is rejoicing right now. He's plugging your life into my vein, and the holy angels are all rejoicing. I pray with you. Father, thank you for the word that came today. Thank you for speaking to our hearts. Thank you because of your word. These words have come out of sin. I pray for grace, oh God, to establish this in no-go area zone in his life, in her life, and nothing will ever be able to change them to go back to sin again in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, because I know on the last day, you will welcome them, welcome me, welcome every one of us on this mountain, your kingdom, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And amen. Praise the Lord.